It is time for the latest and the most comprehensive breakdown of the biggest news stories from Western Visayas and around the country. I am Joseph Diamante. This is Panay News Wrap-Up. Four new test laboratories for COVID-19 set to open soon in Iloilo City and Iloilo Province are seen to improve testing for the viral disease. These are the city government-operated laboratory in Barangay San Pedro Mala District.
The laboratory at the Metro Iloilo Hospital and Medical Center in Barangay Tagbac, Haro District.
The laboratory at the Iloilo Provincial Hospital in Potoban, Iloilo, and the West Visayas State University Medical Center Laboratory in Haro. These will bring to 6 the total COVID test laboratories here. The two currently in operation are at the Western Visayas Medical Center and the Qualamed Hospital, which are both in Mandaruyao District. Mayor Jerry Treñas is hopeful that the releasing of COVID test results will be hastened with the opening of the additional laboratories. Bacolod, the city of more than 500,000 people, woke up on August 9 under a modified enhanced community quarantine status due to rising cases of COVID-19. This, however, was a sudden declaration, according to Metro Bacolod Chamber of Commerce and Industry Executive Director Frank Carbon. Carbon said the government should have first recognized that COVID-19 is not just a crisis in terms of health but also livelihood. He pointed out that 90% of employees in the city are using public transportation and many have already lost their jobs because they worry not only about their health but also what to do every day. The city's quarantine status is until September 30. Cebu City's good practices against COVID-19 now serve as Iloilo City's template to suppress the spread of the viral illness. Interagency Task Force Deputy Chief Implementer for the Visayas, Melquiades Feliciano, and his team met with different cluster heads of Iloilo City's COVID-19 Emergency Operations Center to discuss how to harmonize anti-COVID-19 approaches and activities of the metro. They also tackled how to capacitate laboratories in the city to address the COVID test backlogs. The IATF executive said the aim is to hasten the implementation of all these systems and approaches. There will be no tradition of Ilonggos of visiting the graves of their dead kins, as cemeteries in Iloilo City will close on All Saints Day and All Souls Day to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Mayor Jerry Treñas' executive order on the cemetery closure issued on September 10 cited Republic Act 11469, which stated that LGUs were mandated to act within the letter and spirit of all rules, regulations, and directives of the national government, and for them to fully cooperate in implementing policies related to COVID-19. The closure order also covers columbariums or repositories of urns that contain the ashes of cremated dead people. Violators of the order face appropriate administrative and/or criminal charges for violation of the Bayanihan to Heal as One Act or city ordinances relating to the efforts of the city government and national government to prevent the spread of COVID-19. The closure order, however, may be lifted if the city records no COVID-19 cases. And those were this week's latest headlines. This is Panay News, the number one digital and printed news in the region. Don't forget to always wear your face mask and face shields, sanitize your hands, and observe proper physical distancing. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Stay safe, Western Visayas. Good evening.